I'm going to show you how to use MovCaptioner to put captions on your movies. First thing you want to do when you're going to caption a movie is you want to get organized. You need to have a folder that you're going to put your video, audio, and any of the other exported files into. You're going to open MovCaptioner, hit the load movie, and you'll be able to select which movie you want to use. I usually work off my desktop when I'm working because it's easier for me to find everything. The first way you can use MovCaptioner is to transcribe as you go. You hit the start button and it will repeat that section of audio over and over again as you write it out in the black text box. And when you hit enter, it will put it in the right side in the list box with the time code. And you can select the intervals of time that you use from 1 to 11 seconds. Once you hit the return key, or the enter key, it will save the caption with the time code all the way down until you're at the end of your movie. Then you can preview it using QuickTime, and you can see how the time code lines up with your movie as it plays. And you can also see any spelling mistakes or that should have been capitalized, anything else you might have made a mistake with. You can export the movie or the time codes. You can export the time codes to be put into the movie using QuickTime Pro, or you can export it into other formats as well. You can embed the movie into QuickTime Pro and then you'll have a movie with the time codes that you can show anywhere. You can put it on a disk and show it. Or you can export a subrip file, which you can easily use to caption your movies that you might have on YouTube. The other way that you can create the captions with the time codes is you import a text file and you import it in a paragraph form, and it will fill in the boxes on the right hand side, and then you go through and you can you hit the set time code, and then you hit enter when it gets to the end of each line, and that will set the next time code all the way down your paragraph. If to import a plain text file, you can take any document, you can take a Word document or whatever document you want. You need to save it as a plain text file. One of the ways you can do that is you copy it all and then you paste it into a program like TextEdit on a Mac, or you can paste it into Notepad on a PC, and just make sure you save it as a plain text file, not a rich text, but a plain text file. So again, all you have to do is you hit the set time code and then you hit the return key at the end of each line, and it will set the time code to match your words. Once you export it to QuickTime, if you're going to save it as a movie and you export it to QuickTime Pro, you can save it as a .mov movie, and it will play in QuickTime on either a PC or a Mac. It will also play in iTunes, but it won't play on your iPod or your iTouch. You can look at the iPod link to see how to do that. Or you can export it in QuickTime Pro. You have the option to export as, and you can export it, and you can export it as many different files. They have 3G, they have the iPhone, iPhone Cellular, iPod, the Windows Media Player. So you can export it into many different formats. I like using MovCaptioner for movies that are short, like 20 to 30 minutes or less. The longer the video, it can become labor intensive if you're doing a 2-hour movie. It's great for captioning your videos on YouTube and just creating little text files.